Yes, who are you?
Out of the way and let us pass.
You may pass. But over my dead body.
What did you say?
I don't think you're going to live long.
Because we are alive!
Hello.
Hello and welcome to Connor and Crow's Petrified Picture Show! The most petrifying show that I know, with the word petrifying in it, and show.
Yeah, I can't think of any others that have petrifying.
And show. And like two people with bird names. I think we've nailed that demographic. It's like ours.
Yeah, hands off. Petrifying, you know, it's kind of a weird thing. Petrification related to fear. Do you think that that's like kind of like the whole thing with like a gorgon petrifying people with its hideous visage? Do you think that started the whole petrification when it comes to fear? You know what I mean?
It's turning something into stone, so it's making you like stone. Rigid, like you can't.
Rigid with fear.
You can't move.
I've been rigid with fear a few times in my life, I got to say, but we'll not go into that. But anyhow, but I wonder if those things are related in some way. Maybe, you know.
The word petrification. It's all Latin somewhere. Yeah, it's all probably related.
Yeah. We'll get so scared.
Tonight, we will be showing America Bang Moon Gog, which is also Visitor to America, which is also Bruce Lee fights back from the grave. Yes.
Yes. He's fighting back at least 5 minutes at the beginning. And then.
Yeah. So big disclaimer here, big spoiler. Bruce Lee was already dead when this movie was filmed. I know that's going to like shock and amaze and petrify anybody who's watching this. But alas, Bruce Lee did not take part in this movie, nor did he give any right to this movie, nor did anybody have any permission to include his name in this movie at all. No, there's not.
Just a convincing replica.
Not even convinced. This is a 1976 Bruceploitation flick. So the term Bruceploitation, again, a playoff of exploitation, which is a movie genre known with violence and sexuality and whatever. But the hallmark of this was basically exploiting the name of Bruce Lee to make a movie or promote a movie that did not have anything to do with Bruce Lee.
Can you imagine if like there was other... like there were other forms of Bruceploitation where it wasn't Bruce Lee, but maybe like men who resembled Bruce Willis. And then they, you know, and then it'd be like Bruce Willis conquers
exploitation,
the Martians or whatever, you know, but it's just some man who looks
modern copyright somewhat, would not allow for that, but that would be fan-freaking-tastic.
Yeah.
Oh yeah. Yeah. Just a movie with Bruces, like Bruce Campbell and Bruce Willis and Bruce Springsteen.
Yes.
And
Bruce Dern, just old men.
Yeah, you know. That would be fantastic. The Bruce Squad. And then Bruce Lee, just for fun. And maybe like more than one Bruce.
Yeah.
Bruce Lee, because, you know, that's a thing.
It could be like, what was that? I almost called it The Undesirables. That's not it. It was
Red?
Expendables. Yeah. Or the Expendables, you know, aren't those pretty much the same type of movie
plot,
where it's just like old people,
yeah,
a bunch of old people? But this would be just, it wouldn't necessarily, I mean, they would have
older mercenaries being called back, whereas the, is it The Undesirables or something? Anyway, I know the movie you're talking about, but those are supposed to be people from like specific movies pulled into it, like copies of
action guys.
Action heroes, brought back into a particular movie, which is kind of a cool concept. I don't think they needed to do it as many times as they did, But it was kind of
Those men should not be like running and like leaping around, you know, at that age. Because one false move, and it's like when Harrison Ford was doing like the, what was it, like the last Indiana Jones, and his like hip got crushed by
Indiana Jones and the crystal hip. Yeah.
Crystal hip, yeah.
And the glass hip.
That was natural, by the way. That just, his hip just naturally crystallized.
At that
because
age.
Of his advanced age, yes.
Yeah. I mean, so they're sipping on the water of life that long, and then eventually it's just all minerals. Just,
yeah. And you eventually petrify. You just become
leaches out the minerals and places it with other minerals, which are less durable, clearly, based on the movie, where he was too old to be doing that movie. Not that he's in a badass, but he should have stopped.
Yeah, no, I love him. I'm sure that he could probably still like beat me up, but I mean, I'm sure he would probably die.
Yeah, but that doesn't mean anything. You're a dude in a bird suit. I mean,
that's a good point. My bones are just as hollow as his.
Exactly.
Bone, you know what I mean?
Yeah, you know. I mean, without your kung fu grip, you're going down.
He would like, I would be beaten to a pulp, but then he would just, the fact that he's hitting me with his
bones
hands,
would
his
shatter
bones
on your bones. Right.
Exactly.
Yes.
Nobody
wants
in
to watch
that.
Like that. Well, no, I want to watch that, but again, I'm a bad person. That would be awesome. I would totally watch that.
If we could afford Harrison Ford somehow, I would let him just beat the...
beat the crap out of Condor?
Yes. I'd let him do it. I would feel honored, you know?
All right, so somebody out there, get on that. I believe in you people. Internets?
Yeah, start a GoFundMe. Yes.
Yeah.
But anyway, Bruce.
Yeah.
The Bruce.
Yeah, so we'll talk about the Bruceploitation genre as we get further in, because there's not a lot on this movie. We don't want to blow it in the first 5 minutes.
Yeah.
There's really not a lot in this movie.
You just need to experience it, and then...
Yeah. So, what you're going to be seeing in the first 5 minutes was tacked onto an existing movie to, again, tie into the whole Bruceploitation thing. Apparently, the Terry Levine of Aquarius Releasing went out and grabbed like a camera guy, grabbed some random high school kid, drove them out to a graveyard where they had already dug a hole, and they basically filmed him, the student, in the hole before they got caught by the cops. They got chased out of the graveyard, where they then filmed the rest of it, where he's just kind of jumping up and punching directly into the poster, essentially. They literally stuck the film poster in the movie to give him the bat thing to punch, which actually
say. And you know, and for other amateur filmmakers,
in the movie, it's not just the poster, it's in the movie.
I love it.
That's their budget. That's
I love it. But just some words of advice to amateur filmmakers out there. Nowadays, it's greatly frowned upon to grab high schoolers and drive them off to graveyards
and
without explaining much. So
Yeah. Don't stick
so
kids
don't
in a
do
hole
that now.
And then tell them to uppercut like they're Bruce Lee. Parents do frown
don't
upon
do
that.
You can get
I don't have kids, but I'm assuming that is the sort of thing parents frown upon.
Yes, it is. That's as a parent myself, that's one of our greatest fears is having our kids be in a terrible
movie. Will be abducted and thrown into a hole and forced to duplicate a Bruce Lee scene.
Yes.
I
have nightmares about it. About that exact scenario.
I got the feels just thinking about that. So, without further spoiling anything, let's do this thing.
Thank you.
You think you've had enough? I think it's time you quit.
Why?
Don't you get bored by it all? Kung Fu instruction every day. It's a hell of a way to earn a living.
It's the only thing I know, and I like it.
I don't agree. I'm getting fed up to the teeth. Day after day, the same thing, and there's not any money in it either.
What have you got to moan about?
Well, I need a change.
What for?
I do. I need it. And now. Huh. Not tomorrow. I never took it seriously, you know. That rubbish about sacred principles. I want money in the bank. Huh. That's what counts. Money can buy anything. I need cash.
I don't know what's got into you. What's with you, anyway? Have you forgotten? What you were taught, you're ignoring the teachings. And I don't like that. It could mean trouble for you.
You mean you still believe that crap?
I believe it. Of course I do. Why not?
What for? You're a born loser, man. You're never gonna make it. You need some money.
I need to find fulfillment, and then I'll have lived a good life.
One day, I'll show you what a good life is. I'm not going to waste my time around here. You wait and see. Just give me 3 years. That's all I need. Don't leave it too long before you make it over. I'll be waiting for you.
Your money. Come on. Come on.
Okay. Lenny, your fare, sir.
Why?
And tip, you meant to tip.
Really? That's so? Now get out of here!
Lie down in green pastures. Yea, though I walk through the valley, shadow of death.
Excuse me, miss. Perhaps you can help. Does a Mr. Wong Han live here? Oh, what's wrong? Something the matter?
I'm afraid he's dead.
He's dead?
It's terrible. He was in such good spirits. He went out for a drink. What happened then? I don't know. But yesterday, he was discovered dead. So sudden. He seems to have committed suicide. He fell from a roof. It's terrible. I can't believe it.
Yeah.
Who are you? You know him?
What are you going here, boy? What are you after here?
You don't have any proof at all.
All right, and with that, you have the only thing that's actually Bruce Lee in this movie, which is the noises dubbed over the movie. That's the only actual Bruce content in there. So I forget, who are you? That's a good question, actually. So clearly he's not Bruce Lee. The actor's actual name is Jun Kong, who was then made Bruce K.L. Lee for this movie.
Wasn't he actually Korean?
He was Korean. Of,
yes, yeah.
Yeah, he was a respected Taekwondo instructor who never wanted to be a Bruce Lee clone. But there you go. Sometimes it happens.
Yeah, you don't have a choice. Sometimes you're just a clone.
Yeah. So what we're expected to believe is that Bruce Lee returns from the dead and immediately jumps on a plane and flies back to America. Once in America, he gets mugged in a cab. Once he gets out of that cab, he immediately goes to a gym where they discuss what it's like to work at a gym. I don't know.
Yeah.
Where he then collects his either his brother's body or possibly his best friend's body or possibly his uncle's body, depending on which review of this movie you read. I've read all three of those.
Yeah, there's some details of this movie that aren't exactly clear. But you know, don't let something pesky like details, you know, ruin an entertaining story. What about that fight scene? I mean,
fight scene is pretty cool. I mean, for a guy who was a Taekwondo instructor, that's kind of neat. He did punch a guy through a window. Why yeah, there was a black guy with a hand axe wearing a cape looking for him, though, that's a question I want answered. I mean, fashion choice. That is bold.
It was. I like that. I like that guy's energy. I liked his whole thing. He's just wearing a cape with no shirt, and he's got an axe. And he's just
cape and ready to axe. I mean, that's like D&D Barbarian.
Yeah.
Going through also these streets of some city. Los Angeles. Los Angeles. Never mind.
There are weirder things than that in Los Angeles.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. It's fine. Now that I've reread that it's Los Angeles, I'm okay with it. It's no longer quite as bold.
I mean, that's an everyday thing.
Yeah.
But also, I think isn't there's some sort of martial arts that does use like a hand axe. I don't know. I can't remember what it. I think it is like a type of it may be like an axe. It might be like slightly different, but like Yeah, I don't know where I'm going with that. But anyway, the whole point is...
There probably is. Maybe
there's a cultural significance that we're unaware of. Probably not.
To the hand axe and a cape?
This movie. Yeah.
I mean...
Don't you know the myth of the hand axe cape wearer who, you know, travels...
If that is a movie out there, I would like to watch it. But no, I don't know the significance of that particular fashion statement. I don't.
Asia and, you know, in search of worthy opponents. I don't know. I could imagine flinging his cape aside to distract them as he hurls a hand axe at them.
I mean, there was a whole Master of a Flying Guillotine where they all had like different weapon techniques and stuff. So maybe it was a callback to that. I mean, I can give him that, maybe. Sure.
Yeah. I mean, I think universally an axe is a pretty good weapon anyway. I mean, you know, you're just hacking somebody to bits. That's
don't
pretty effective.
Don't bring a hand axe to a kung fu fight.
Yeah, but I guess in this case it wasn't such a good idea.
No, so that failed. No.
I like the kick through the, that was cool, through the glass. And the guy's like, oh, and he flies through. That was pretty great.
We could do it up while he's cuddling his dead uncle brother's best friend's bones. And that was also kind of weird. I'm assuming that was supposed to be cremated, but it just kind of went into a dark closet and came out in a pile of bones. Like, do you have a bunch of, like, scarab beetles in there? What the hell was that?
That's just the bone closet. You just throw them in there.
Like,
then,
there's a monster in there that goes, bones.
Yeah.
And then
the bones come out. They debone the body, and then, you know, and then they give you the bones.
I mean, if that's a burial method, I want that one. I was okay with just being, like, rolled in a ditch, but if I can be devoured by a monster and then spit back out on a conveyor belt, I'm choosing that one.
Just give my family the wet bones.
Yeah.
You know, I mean, provided that they haven't been broken by Harrison Ford. I'm still holding out for that GoFundMe, you know. But I was thinking about this movie, or something about this movie reminded me of... Once Upon a Time in Hollywood, and the whole scene with Bruce Lee fighting Brad Pitt. And I think this is something that happened, and this kind of goes along with what we were talking about with the Expendables and with Red.
Expendables. They're like, there you go.
Yeah,
that's
I thought it was...
Not the Undesirables, Expendables. There we go.
But I think there's something that happens in, like, many male actors' lives where they age and they have to prove their machismo somehow by still pretending that they're capable of things that nobody really buys, you know, like nobody really expects this to happen. Like with Brad Pitt, how old is Brad Pitt now? Like Brad Pitt is like probably in his like late 50s or something, right?
Yeah.
Probably. And I'm not saying he's obviously in good shape. He's all obviously taking care of himself, but I don't buy that he, even though this is his character, he's a stuntman. I don't know. I kind of don't buy him being able to take Bruce Lee. You know what I mean? I mean,
no.
I don't know. And also, there's
Bruce
a scene
Lee
in that
now,
movie where some,
yes. I mean,
yo, yes.
Brad Pitt now versus Bruce Lee now. Yes.
Yeah, no contest.
That is
no
a fair contest. Fight. No, it's at least fair.
Yeah.
I don't know if it's even, but it's fair.
Yeah. Well, then he's got this other movie that he's in now that's Bullet Train, where it's a similar situation where he's on it. Well, I mean, he's not fighting Bruce Lee, but he's on a train and he's fighting all these assassins.
It's a martial arts movie. Yeah.
It's a martial arts movie. And I don't know. It's weird that happens. Do you think it is just like a male insecurity type thing where you're just like, I got to prove that I've still got it? Or, you know?
Probably. I mean, Tom Cruise is still trying to prove he can fly a jet, you know?
Yeah, that's true. And also in his Mummy movie that came out a few years ago, he's still trying to play people that are in their 30s when he's well past that.
Yeah.
I don't know. It's just such a strange thing, you know? I mean, you could just wander quietly into the twilight years and just do dramas or something, you know?
I'm just going to gracefully keep going green until I die.
Yeah, just get... Yeah, I think that's
more
a good
more
idea.
Green until
natural
until
state more, of decomposition.
More green and more scan lines until I finally pass. It'll just be a blip. Yep. That'll be me. Yep. That's how I plan on going.
That's, you know, as is intended, as biology would intend you to transcend into a state of static, just pure energy,
just pure chaos, much like I was in life.
Yeah. Chaos. From chaos you came, from chaos you will remain. But anyway, let's get back to this.
Yeah, we'll get back to the movie. Absurd. We'll discuss some more Bruceploitation at the next break. And hopefully between now and then, something else will break. Like somebody's face, or a wall, or some more glass. Let's do this thing.
So I your story that it was self-defense. What can I do? You could get the chair.
And what sort of chair is that?
You what? That's with this guy. He wants his own special kind.
He wants to have his own maid.
The fool!
Are you putting us on? Give us some proof. Are you gonna fraud, boy?
I told you I don't have any.
God damn you!
I told you. What's the matter with you? This is meant to be a democracy. You can't push people around. I've got my rights.
Oh, your rights. You got your rights, boy. Yeah, it is meant to be a democratic country, but you still need to have proof, and you'll need bail, otherwise I'm gonna lock you up. And then you can rot in prison until we meet in court and sort it out there.
I don't know anyone.
In that case, be our guest. You can make yourself at home here.
Well, nothing would surprise me. I've learned to be philosophical about this kind of thing.
What the hell is this guy on about anyway? Can you tell me that, for Christ's sakes?
Nothing really. These Orientals are all the same. They think different. That's all there is to it.
Well, I don't trust his fancy talk. Hello. Yeah, I understand. All right, I'll let him go. Yo, free to go. Get the hell out of here, do you hear me? Get out!
I'm not surprised. A sudden change of fortune's in the scheme of things. Thank you, sir.
God damn you!
There's someone who wants to meet you.
Who is it?
You'll soon find out. Get in the car.
Excuse me.
Oh.
The name is Scott Lee. What is yours?
Wong Han. Are you a Chinese? You sound American.
My grandfather. He was from China.
Oh, really? Was he? Nice to meet you. It's very kind of you.
There's no need to thank me. Please, sit yourself down. Please. Did they tell you who put up the bail for your release?
Not yet.
Do you know who bailed you out?
No, I don't know, and I'm not sure I understand.
I did. It cost me $2,500.
But why?
Because I like you.
That the only reason?
No, it's not. I want you to find her.
Oh. Who is she?
I'll pay well. You'll get $5,500 when you're finished. Hold it. Reconsider. Chinese know how to be grateful.
Sorry, I don't mean to disappoint you, but there's something about the way you made your request I don't quite like. I must turn you down.
Do you want?
Leave her alone.
Damn you!
Thank you. It's strange. America is meant to be free, but what a lie. Nothing is free in this country. Everything has a price on it.
Is he why you've come here? Oh, you're on a visit, or are you working here?
I have a problem. Go Hog Han, does the name mean anything to you? I came here to meet him. You ever met him yourself?
Oh, why should the name mean anything to me?
You've heard about him. You read of his death in the papers.
Oh, I read that he committed suicide, but why are we discussing
this? It wasn't suicide. He had become a very wealthy businessman. He'd everything going for him. He'd no reason to kill himself. Something must have happened to him. You know something?
All right, I'll tell you. Cafe where I work as a waitress. I'll tell you about it over coffee, okay? Well, let's see. Where shall I begin now? It must be about 2 years ago, he decided to open up his own gymnasium. With the money he'd managed to accumulate over the years, through hard work and putting a bit aside each week, you know. But the gym also had a Turkish bath. I worked for him there to pay my college fees. Anyway, it was a great success. Almost immediately, we were turning customers away. It soon became the in place to go, and within a year, he'd made it clear $50,000. It was really fantastic. But it wasn't to last. He had some bad luck. It was really terrible. A pupil, young kid, was a lawyer's son. During his practice, he tried to break a brick by using his head. He hurt himself. The father chose to sue to take him to court, and he got a huge amount in damages. The lawyer knew his law, and he won the case. He took Go Hok Han for every single cent that he'd saved. He was broke, without a penny in the world. Then one day, a group of strangers came to see him.
What happened to him?
Nothing at all. They talked briefly, and then he followed them.
After that?
He just disappeared. Nothing was heard for 4 months. But then one day, he suddenly turned up again, and everything returned to normal. Shortly after that, he received your telegram. Then he went for a drink. Next thing I heard, he was dead.
Thank you.
Are you leaving now?
I've heard all I wanted. You've been most helpful. I need some time to think. I'll see you soon. Bye.
Like that?
What do you expect me to do?
Say something.
Like what?
Well, first of all, introduce yourself, even though it's a coincidence that we met at all. You did rescue me. That doesn't just happen every day, you know. Well, say something. Don't just stand there.
Yeah, I guess you're right there.
Hello, I'm Susan Clark.
How do you do?
What's your name?
Wong. Wong Han.
Wong Han, what are you doing tonight?
How should I know what I'm going to do?
Tell me.
What do you mean?
I mean, where are you going to go to?
I've got nowhere. I don't know a single soul in this city of Los Angeles.
Well, then, where are you going to go?
Where my fancy takes me, I guess.
Really? Your fancy just go anywhere?
I'll wander around.
You poor boy. I've got a better idea. Why not come home with me?
Where to?
Come on.
You don't have to, you know.
Come off it. You did do me a great favor today, didn't you?
I suppose so.
All right. Teach me the art of self-defense.
Okay.
I like how cowboy's its own category. You know, a Japanese guy, and a black guy, and a white guy, and a Mexican, and a cowboy.
I know.
Anyway, a distinct category, like on the census, you can check the box, you're cowboy. And that's a thing.
His race was cowboy.
His race was cowboy. So right where we started this particular section, at the very meeting where that guy is shirtless in the car and he's trying to strangle her or do something. Yeah, that was a point where, and the 70s, like, porn music starts playing. I'm like, wait, whoa. What kind of movie did
it's
I just
that put? Kind of party.
I was like, yeah, like, I mean, I don't mind those kind of movies, but that's not what I sat down to watch.
Right.
So I had questions.
You got to switch gears.
Yeah. But luckily, you know, Wong Han came out and kicked the guy in the face and all was well.
Well, something that's very funny about this movie and many other movies that are dubbed, which we've talked about before, is the voice acting. I mean, this is as bad as like a giallo movie. I mean,
oh yeah.
It's just so absurd.
Even the people who should be speaking English, it's clearly dubbed over.
I love the scene in the police, in like the, at the police station with the guns up against the shotguns up against the wall, and just the police chief, like, just he's really had it and everything, you know. I mean,
fool,
just very over the top. Yeah. He's like, "You're in big trouble now, boy." And then they get a call and they're like, "Hey, he's free to go." And he's like, "God damn you." And then he goes, out of nowhere, he goes from just being pissed to then all of a sudden he has a brief moment of like, something occurs to him. He has an epiphany, I guess.
An epiphany. A moment of catharsis and all was well. You know, yeah. He had that sudden moment of clarity. I don't really need to arrest this man.
He came to his senses. But, yeah. You know, in a similar dubbing situation with this woman, all these moans that they decided to add in. I mean,
exactly. It was like, what kind of movie is this? Does she enjoy being mugged? Does she like leave the door unlocked? And this is what she does before going to work? Again, no judgment. You know, everybody's got their thing. Yeah. But yeah, that's not the movie I signed up to watch.
Right. Yeah. I mean, you know, again, though, I guess this goes back to it being L.A., you know, this type of thing just happens, you know, in L.A., I guess.
I think apparently. Yeah, sure. Let's go with that.
Because I have a feeling that that man is not going to be associated with the villains of this movie. He just happens to be a creep is what
he's just be a my random thought. Shirtless white guy who likes, what was he even doing, like trying to lick her ear? I don't know. It was weird.
I don't know. I was kind of worried for a moment he was going to try to snap her neck, and then it seemed like he had sort of a more lascivious.
That would have made a little more sense. I would have understood that. But maybe that's just like the American expectation of violence. I don't know.
Yeah, that could be. Because, you know, we're allowed to show a lot of violence on basic cable, but we're not usually allowed to show nudity or sex or anything.
Right, so I might have been primed for like, okay, he's going to like stab her in the neck. But wait, he's licking her? What? No.
Yeah.
No. That's not. That's not. Is that what he's doing? No. No. Wait. Yes. No. Yes.
And then he just goes to, you know, then he lays down on her on the pavement of all places.
Yeah.
Not a gentleman at all.
Right in the way for a face kicking.
Yeah, exactly. Also, the way that this movie is shot is very strange. There are some moments where, or maybe it's just how it is on my end, but like I couldn't tell, like when they were on top of that building.
Oh, were what they were looking at? No, yeah. No, you can't tell. No, that's just the way it is. Literally, I was sitting there going, what are they looking at? What is he chasing? And even when he like ran, I thought he was going to like jump across a building or something because you're immediately looking down at his feet. I was like, okay, they're priming for like a foot scene. He's going to run. He's going to jump.
It could be like a parkour type thing. Yeah.
Something off the ground. You can't even tell what it is. It was like a piece of garbage.
She's like, let's get out of here. Let's go to the cafe.
From three blocks away, there's a man littering. Hold on a second.
That's what she was gasping about. She hates litter bugs. That's why she was gasping. She's
the audacity. Makes much sense of anything. But otherwise, no, the like line of sight, you can't tell what the hell either of them are looking at.
Very strange. Very, very strange.
Yeah.
But again, details are inconsequential when it comes to this.
No, you don't need it with a plot this complex. And I'm still waiting for that plot to arrive.
Don't hold your breath.
But yeah, just wanted that brief aside on cowboys, and we'll cover some more in a bit.
Yeah.
All right, here we go.
It isn't my place. I just look after it for $100 a month. While the owner's away from town on his annual vacation. Come on, come in.
Okay.
Make yourself at home. Come on. You can put your bags down over here. Oh. Let me help.
Right, now, shall we begin?
Oh, why all the hurry? Would you like a drink first? Coffee?
Milk, please. Okay. First lesson. Stand like this. Your turn. Ready?
Oh, well, what do you say? Have I got it right?
Better than that, you're good.
Oh, no, I don't believe you.
Really? You learn very fast.
Just a minute. You'll need some money. Take this.
What for?
It's for you, for your tuition.
No, you shouldn't.
But it's the right thing to do.
You can pay me something else.
Like what?
Let's go to your bedroom. Oh. Now, sit down a moment. Now, listen to me. I want you to think carefully. Can you remember what those five men looked like who took Hawk Han away?
I think I can. Each of them seemed to play a part, like an actor, you know.
The black one, was he exceptionally tall and thin? A flashy dresser, wearing an earring?
Oh, yes, you're right. He'd a large gold one. It looked so good, I wanted it for myself.
Susan?
Yeah?
Please, do me a favor.
Oh, what?
I want to find all of them. There are still four I have not met. You are the only one who knows what they look like and where I might find them. You must help me. You're my only hope.
How can? It's impossible. I don't know where they are by now. They could be anywhere in Los Angeles, for all I know. This is an enormous city, you know.
I understand. Los Angeles is an enormous city.
It's impossible.
No, it isn't. Not for men like them. They need meeting places where they make contact. Crooks use the same old dives week after week. So, will you help me? Please.
Oh, all right.
Good, thank you. Bye-bye.
Listen, where are you going to go to now, at this hour of the night?
This is your house. It's not permitted for me to stay here. Please, will you keep these for me? I'll return for them in the morning. I'll see you then. Have a good night's sleep. Au revoir.
Night. Oh, my God, not on a park bench, weren't you cold? It was freezing out.
Uh-huh.
You'll catch pneumonia if you're not careful. Where are we supposed to go after we've had breakfast? Well, I'm ready to face the world. What do you suggest we do first?
You can start the car.
Where to?
You said last night there was a Chinatown here.
Yes, there is.
All right, then take me there.
Chinatown it is.
Stop the car. No, you wait here. Watch where you're walking. You trot on my shoe. Your boss is expecting me. He knows who I am. Even if you're too thick to understand anything. Now, you take me to him.
Mm-hmm.
Well, where's your boss?
Are you all right, huh?
I'm okay. Did you see him?
Yes, I saw him running away. He seemed to be in an awful hurry, though.
Are you sure he's one of the men who left with Gohog, huh?
Yes, I'm sure.
Good. In that case, we'd better be going. Come on. Susan! Susan! Susan!
To pick me up now after I've finished work, huh?
Hmm.
Wait, you'll need some money, won't you? I know you don't have any. Really, I can spare it for now. After all, I'm going to pick up my wages later.
Okay, I'll pay you back. Bye.
I'm looking for this karate school.
Hey,
Hey, you! Come back here!
Have to feel bad for poor Susan there. I mean, she gets the crap kicked out of her waiting on him. Gets saved through like excessive acupuncture. Lends her car out and some money. And she just does like a waitress job. And then he doesn't even pick her up because he goes to some school, beats the crap out of some students after a long walk sequence that didn't really go anywhere.
Yeah.
And then ditches her to watch a parade.
Yeah, gets distracted by the parade going on. I love that weird, like, brief scene where the music is playing when he's at the fair, or I mean, at the parade, and then it ends and shows her looking around.
Yeah, like,
and then it goes right back to the music and then shows him, choices. Like the way they drop this. Very strange.
Yeah, I was like, okay, I see what you're going. It's a revenge thing. He finds out the five people who, like, beat the crap out of his best friend, yeah. So, who beat the crap out of his uncle, brother, with the best friend and faked his suicide, I guess.
Yeah.
He gets one of them. Okay, cool. We're doing this thing. We're following the path of revenge. And then he goes to a parade and gets distracted.
Yeah. Also, are we to think that the cowboy was the one that threw the shuriken at the guy and killed him because of the horse riding off, or what?
Maybe. I thought that it was going, when he went to the school, I thought he was following the cowboy, but then I was like, no, wait, it's him wearing a cowboy hat. Okay, I don't know where that's going.
Yeah.
And then he just, like, beats the crap out of all the students, which was cool. That, like, spin kick, whatever the hell thing he did, would, like, beat the crap out of all the ones. I was like, all right, I'm engaged.
Yeah.
And then he just walks out. It's like, wait, what? What? Where was that going?
This is one of the movies that, like, has pretty good, like, fight scenes, but just the story is just very strange and hard to follow. And so basically just like an average movie that we would show on here
pretty much. But it is a hallmark of Bruce exploitation. So the idea behind it was that when Bruce Lee died suddenly unexpectedly, he didn't leave a will or anybody to manage the estate. So anybody who had unfinished footage or training footage or whatever else, they just kind of ran with it. And intertwined parts of those scenes with other movies, or just kind of took his name and threw it onto a movie that had nothing to do with it, like this one.
Yeah.
So that's a hallmark of this particular thing is, fight scenes stuck into some movie. There you go. It's a Bruce Lee movie now. Ha ha!
Well, like I said, I wish that would catch back on if people weren't so litigious these days, if anything happened to, God forbid, happened to, Bruce Willis or Bruce Dern, which I think it'd be more likely would happen to Bruce Dern since he's, 1,000 years old.
Yeah.
But just like, you're like, hey, we need a bald guy,
an action movie with him at 1,000 years old. Yeah. I would watch that.
Stern's just like,
like with like Bruce Lee sound effects dubbed over it.
Yeah.
That'd be fucking fantastic.
But whenever he would actually have to do any sort of real fighting, it would just be like a stuntman with like a clearly
plastic mask. Spirit Halloween mask.
Yeah. And he's just, you know, beating everybody up.
Yeah. And then it cuts back to him.
And he's like, had enough.
Yeah. I would watch that.
Absolutely. Are we ready?
I was just commenting on, I don't know where this is going. I think this is the third time I've watched this, and at this point I'm like,
it's easy to get sort of lost in the silliness of it all, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
You know, it's like, I feel like it sort of makes me feel like the people that made it were very ADD addled their brains, because they're just like, hey, this is it's a revenge path, but then, you know, we're gonna make he gets distracted by this and that,
but then they got distracted at the parade and like blew all of their film budget filming the parade and had to build the rest of the movie around it.
Exactly,
that makes sense. I would believe that.
That's definitely the energy that this film gives off, for sure.
And so it does have like a lot of time left, and he still has to beat the crap out of four people, at least four.
Yeah,
I think at least
four. Well, unless the guy with the axe is that kid. I mean,
no, that was one of them.
Well, yeah, does he have to fight them to the death, or is it concluded after he just beats them up?
I don't know. How far would you go if you're...
Do they have an understanding afterwards? Or wait, did he actually kill the guy?
I don't think so. Well, it wasn't really shown. I mean, he did go to jail briefly until he was released.
In the police station, they were like, you know, wanting to really lock him up. And
right.
So I don't know. I don't know, but I didn't hear him break a window. Dead.
People care more about property damage than they do about people. That's damage.
True. Yeah, the police especially. Yeah. Exactly.
But anyway, hopefully we have at least four more fight sequences ahead. Otherwise, I don't know where this movie's going.
I figure they're either going to do four separate ones, or it's just going to be
one giant montage
where he has to fight them all. A montage situation where he just show them, you know. It's like, kick it to the limit. His plan is like beating it. They should have seen him beating
him. And he just spin kicks all of them at once.
Yeah. And then that's just the end of it. Then that's it.
I would believe that.
Just sort of ends.
Just ends. Okay. Let's see what happens. We'll get back to this.
Thank you. Hey, Susan. Sorry to be late, but the car was stolen.
Oh, come on, round the corner. What? Come. Where are they? They were here.
Susan, let's go back.
What happened?
Come.
This is a good one here.
Well, how much are you asking?
For you, $60 a week. It's a giveaway, lady. Oh, that's $40 a week, and that's my rock-bottom price, dear.
It looks good,
It's an attractive color.
Well, the paper's
good
anyway.
Everything about it's good, lady, I'm telling you.
How much for this one over here, huh?
For you, my dear, $70 a week. It's a bargain.
What
excellent condition. It's
it
the best
buy. Does it have a radio and a cassette recorder?
Of course it has everything in it.
Oh!
It's got everything you want, lady. It's a bargain. Huh? I'm telling you.
Hey,
come back here, lady. You missed a bargain, I'm telling you. Lady, you missed a bargain.
Here you are. I found just the right thing for us over there.
Susan, this is the one. Let's get it.
This one? You sure?
Yeah. $50 a week's okay.
But that's all I've got.
But we save on hotel bills.
Well, how long are we going to stay here?
Till I find the rest of those guys and get myself a job. You saw that man with the black hat, did you? Could you see what he looked like?
I don't know. He had his hat pulled down. I couldn't see, but he looked horrible. It was terrifying. Hey, wait. I think someone's inside.
Are you looking for me?
Are you Sasaki?
Yes, I am.
Did you kill him?
Why say that? Why should I commit murder?
Someone killed him.
Gohak Han was mixed up in all kinds of shady business dealings. Did you know that?
Such as, tell me.
Such as drug smuggling.
I don't believe you.
That's up to you. But you had better listen to me for your own damn good. Understand?
Your threats don't frighten me one little bit.
You should be.
Why, what are you gonna do about it?
Hold it! Why should I help you?
All right, if you can't help me, then who can?
Mark Welby.
Where can I find him?
You can try the race course.
I've some questions for him.
That's if you live to ask them.
Did you see anything?
Not a thing.
God damn it, where have they gone? Look, there they are.
I'll go and search the rest of the house.
looking for me? Now you hear me. You do want me, don't you? Well, now you found me. You're to hand over everything you've got.
Yeah.
Sides here. Cool, cool. So, one, against the fight, the Mexican guy, he totally should have pulled on a luchador mask as he got in the ring.
Mm-hmm.
Two, did he seriously grab a chunk of his beard, rip it out, and then blow it back in his face? Did I see that? Was that a thing that happened?
Yeah, I think that I'm pretty sure that there is another Bruce Lee, like an actual Bruce Lee movie, where he does something similar to someone, but I don't think it's
the dude's beard out.
Maybe not their beard, but maybe like chest hair or something, and like blows up their face. I don't know. It seems familiar. It seemed like a familiar move I've seen before.
Okay,
I'll have to look at them. But yeah, rude. No, it was a missed opportunity for a luchador situation.
Oh, that'd
sure.
be fantastic. I mean, that is the only thing that made that better. Was like, all right, you come over here, come into the ring. All right, then he pulls out like his mask.
Yeah,
he's now El Diablo.
Yeah, and he
and
would
then starts
like,
tossing around the ring, like completely goes a different style altogether. That would have been fantastic.
Like if
that was
been,
a lost
like,
opportunity.
More agile, like, more, oh, yeah. like more surprisingly agile for a big guy. That would have been really cool.
That would have been fantastic.
But even so, it was an all right fight scene. The beard pulling, man, it hurts to have your beard pulled. I mean,
I mean, ripped out, like ah.
Yeah, my kids have like grabbed fistfuls of my beard before and yanked it, and it's not fun.
Oh,
yeah. Makes me want to body slam.
All right, that's all I wanted to cover. All right, let's get back to it.
Yeah, yeah. No, I'm glad that you did. I was right with you.
Like, oh, ow, no, 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 no.
You better make him speak to us. Why is he looking for us, huh?
Let's go. Tell the trainer.
All right.
Come on, you bastard. Ouch. If you refuse to speak to me or don't tell the truth, I'll fill you so full of holes you'll be just like a pincushion.
You.
All right, you bastard, I'll make you talk. Now, why did you murder Gohak Han? Come on, talk. And why are you interested in this girl? Huh?
Bastard.
Oh.
Looking for the drugs. So that means the girl hasn't got them.
You can't make a move. He'll be a dead man.
Oh.
Now, where's the drugs? I swear I'll kill you if you dare lie to me. We know Goha Khan didn't have the drugs on him. He was supposed to deliver an assignment to Taipei, but he was intercepted and died for his pains. But he passed it on. He must have given it to you because he had no friends in the States. He didn't know anyone except you. Now hand them over. How'd you guess?
But you're dead. You committed suicide, didn't you?
I took you in as well. It was a trick. I put a substitute in my place, relying on you to take the urn back to my family in Taipei. However, things didn't work out.
Well, you've succeeded very well so far.
The drugs are worth $1 million. In other words, 5 million Hong Kong. A lot. And I could have been set up for the rest of my natural life. But that's all finished now.
You're crazy. You'd have never have got away with it. You'd have been hunted down and they'd have killed you. And how could you betray your own friend?
You're right, how could I? But I was counting on you. I knew you. I figured you wouldn't let me down. I knew that you'd take the urn and return it to my family.
But now it's all gone wrong. And it's all because of you.
Not my fault.
No? Well, now I'm gonna kill you. You fool, you. You're no match for me. I'll break you apart. Just wait and see. I'll snap your bones. You've lost the right to live.
Well, we all have to die one day. Your time's now. You shouldn't upset yourself too much.
See now who your Chinese friend
is? Aye. FBI narcotic squad. We've had you under surveillance all the time. We knew Go was still alive, so we released you on bail, hoping you would find him.
But I'm afraid we couldn't tell you about it. Otherwise, you might have blown a whole operation. We've been working on this case for over a year now.
Please, you mustn't hold it against us. Let's be going. Hmm?
You'll get a medal for all the help you've given us.
I've got this. Okay, so this guy flies to America to avenge his best friend, uncle, father, whatever. Finds the body. They show him the body. Body gets shoved into that closet, and then the bones get pushed back, at which point they do the old bait and switch. All right, all right. So they hand him the urn, at which point I'm assuming holds all those bones.
Yeah.
He stays with the waitress briefly. The waitress is in on it. Who he gives that box to save briefly, because he does have an apartment to live in.
Right.
When she has it in her possession, she swaps out the bones, just kind of dumps it out in the trash can, fills it up with money and drugs, so that he will take the urn back to his home country, at which point his uncle, best friend, father will jump out and say, ha ha, I'm alive, and take it from him.
Yeah, kill him and take it, I guess. Yeah.
How am I doing? Is that what you got out of this?
So, I guess. Now, I don't know. I don't even know what to say, really.
It was all a complex plot between law enforcement and the FBI using him as a decoy to bring out the uncle, father, best friend.
But in the midst of their whole situation, their whole plot to have him lead them to that, to the guy who faked his death, they allowed multiple people to die.
Yeah.
You know?
And why did the like gang leader allow his entire gang to get killed if he was like just gonna be like, oh no, I'm alive now? I mean, I guess he had enough money at that point to just rehire his entire staff.
I guess. And what was really their like motivation for helping him? I mean, maybe they just they were already his business associates. Well, they thought, I guess
that she had the drugs because supposedly uncle, best friend, father had a bunch of drugs that went missing because they were going to kill him to get the drugs.
Right. Yeah. Okay.
Okay. So they weren't the same gang. Wait. Okay. So it's two separate gangs. All right. Now I'm a little bit further along. Okay. Two separate gangs. The five guys, and then the uncle, best friend, father, plotting against each other.
Somehow
the waitress was involved, so that explains why the waitress kept having money to like pass him.
Yeah,
she was not a waitress; she was a drug mule.
But then, why would she, if she knew though? Do you think she would really risk her life to prevent them from getting their hands on her? I mean, because she just was like the cowboy's like, "I'm gonna give you to the count of three or whatever," and she's like.
Clearly she was making a lot of really bad decisions.
Right.
You know? Because she kept getting the crap kicked out of her, like at all times.
Yeah. I don't know, man.
Such a jerk to her, too. I mean, dude.
Yeah.
Just made some bad decisions in her life. She didn't deserve to get shot down in the desert. And did he just drive away and leave her?
Well, he ran. Well, yeah, he did. Yeah,
he got in the car and he drove off to get his box of drugs, right? So he just left her there, shot down in the desert, right?
Right. It's so funny, though, because I know the cops wanted to get their man, but it's just, they really allowed so many people to die just to get this one guy who they just ended up killing anyway. That they just ended up shooting him in the first place.
Now that we have him.
Yeah.
Thank you for bringing him out of hiding. We knew he was alive. Like you could do like surveillance and find him a different way.
Right. And they really took a gambit like not stopping him before he almost killed the main character. I mean, you know, it's
or counting on him even coming to the country in the first place.
Right. Yeah. That's a.
We're just going to sit around and wait for a year and see if anybody comes to claim the body.
Yeah.
Anybody? Yep. Nope. Yep. Wait. Oh, he's here now. We got to let him go. All right. Let him go.
Perfect. Exactly what we've been waiting for all this time. This exact scenario.
How long is that body on ice? I mean, even if you like stick it in a drawer somewhere, they don't last.
No.
And they were doing this thing for a year.
I also love just the hand waving of "I had a double." Oh, okay. Why and how?
I don't even think it was a double. I think it was like him that they push into that closet and then they stuck a bunch of bones on the conveyor belt and like rolled it down. And the main character was so dumb that he just didn't pick up on that.
Yeah.
Like, what's your cow bones?
He seemed very. It was almost like his character was from another time period or like, because it was more than, it just seemed more than like a culture situation, you know, like a, you know, different culture, because he's like very enamored by the parade, you know, it's like, what, he come out of a goddamn time machine or something, you know what I mean? It's just like,
I mean, he did come back from the dead, you know, maybe that had some lasting effects.
How long had he been dead? I mean, it's not like decades had passed since he had.
But still, you know.
What year is
this? Yeah.
Like, it's a few months after you died, man.
It was the effect of coming back from the dead. So if he felt cheated by the whole back from the dead thing. All right. So you could check out. Let's see.
We all feel cheated.
Dragon Lives Again.
So, and this Bruce Lee, but, you know, not Bruce Lee. It's Bruce Leng Si Long. Bruce Lee dies, is sent to hell for reasons.
For some reason.
Opens a gym.
He knows what he did.
He knows what he did. So he opens a gym in hell where he's doing quite well up until the wives of Satan come in and interrupt him, as they do, at which point he takes on the denizens of hell, which include, all right, Dracula, James Bond, the man with no name from A Fistful of Dollars, and Popeye.
Well, yeah. I mean, he's screwed if he has to go up against Popeye. Jesus. You know.
Also known as the Deadly Hands of Kung Fu.
Oh my god, that sounds like a real romp.
It's actually, it's not good. No, I'm going to tell you, it's not good. Did I watch it? Yes.
Well, yeah, I mean, like, with a description like that, how can you not?
How can you not? So, but if that's not absurd enough, watching him, so this would be like a prequel to this movie, you know, how he escapes from hell. If that movie's not absurd enough, you got, all right, let's see. This includes the clones of Bruce Lee, which features not just one Bruce Lee, but four, none of them played by Bruce Lee, all trained to fight crime in Southeast Asia until the scientist who creates them goes rogue because he isn't credited properly.
Do they all shriek? Do they all shriek while they're doing kung fu?
Yeah, my God. Yeah.
Can you imagine just being overwhelmed by clones of Bruce Lee that are just beating the shit out of you while they're screeching the entire time? What a nightmare.
And they're all trained by Dragon Lee, which is, again, the fight sequences are pretty cool. The basic plot, not so much. There's no plot.
Yeah. Well, it's part and parcel.
And if you need some more information on any of this, check out These Fizz Break Bricks by Grady Hendrix and Chris Poggiali, which I'm probably pronouncing wrong. But yeah. It's really awesome. It's how I found this movie initially. How I found this movie exists. I was like, I must find this movie. Was by reading that book.
We put a link in the description. In the
When I do the show notes, I'll put that out there. It's Grady Hendrix does cool things. That's nonfiction about not exclusively Bruce Lee, but it does cover the Bruce exploitation as a genre, and how the whole martial arts genre became a thing in America and everywhere else. But mostly America, because we care.
We just really, we're very much in love with our entertainment, you know, and I think that that's normal. I mean, it's normal to us because we are Americans, but I think also in a way, the horrors of reality are a lot to deal with. So, you know, spending a lot of time on entertainment makes sense for your sanity's sake, you know. So you don't get crushed by despair. Despair.
You really just don't need to think. Any of those movies mentioned tonight will do it.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
They will numb your brain in a pleasing manner.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Bruce Lee versus Dracula and James Bond. And there's a whole bunch of other ones. I mean, it's a whole cast of people who ended up in hell, apparently.
Yeah, well, I think that really says a lot about the impact that Bruce Lee left on the world. As silly as that might sound in this case, just because it's almost a parody. But no, I mean, he really, there was nobody really else like him, you know? And
he gave it a name brand recognizability, is what he gave it. So he kind of gave it a sort of level of, and a respectability before they completely went the other way with it.
Yeah. I mean, you have to think this is like the way that they did that with that subgenre. It's almost like the only thing that I can think of that's even close to it, and it's not even a film type, but like sort of, it's almost like the whole Chuck Norris phenomenon that was popular in the early 2000s with like, just sort of like make like in a way,
the memes?
Because those were really like proto memes in a way, because that was like, you know, but it's almost like that. It's almost like this is the film version of a meme, you know, that category, that subgenre is sort of like,
I look at it kind of like a fan fiction.
Yeah. You know? Yeah. That's
Yeah, so we're going to write our own story featuring Bruce Lee, and it's going to be as weird as we want it to be because you can't tell us not to.
Right.
Or you should tell us not to, but because Bruce Lee didn't leave a will and his wife and young kid couldn't fight back legally, which kind of sucks, but you know. Hey, we got these out of it.
What are you going to do, you know? I mean, it is what it is. But, you know, speaking of that, like, as far as, like, using people, real-life people to tell bizarre stories and having no legal recourse, I want to know how the author, Chuck Tingle, gets away with writing all these bizarre Kirk Cameron novels. Have you heard any of them? I don't know how he gets...
I haven't seen it specifically, but I would believe it. Parody. As long as it's weird enough that it's parody and it's not libel, you could probably get away with it.
Okay. Well, anyone who's not familiar with Chuck Tingle, he writes a series. He writes a lot of bizarre erotic novels. Some of them involve monsters or strange creatures.
A lot of creatures.
And dinosaurs engaging in all kinds of sexual acts with
everything.
Kirk Cameron and other people.
Everything. If
everything,
a thing.
Yeah. So, yeah. You know, it's I would like to think that Chuck Tingle has a lot to answer for not thanking Bruce Lee for, you know, Bruce Ploitation being sort of a, I don't know, I'm trying to tie those.
I think it's a combination of things. I think one, parody law is fairly strong, and two, he would actually have to go to court and say what's in those things that is not actually true.
No, I think, like, especially on for Kirk Cameron, if he were to do that, I think he would probably, I mean, he'd be so embarrassed, I think.
That's what I'm saying. It's like, yeah. No, Your Honor, I did not have sex with a toaster, as indicated by Mr. Tingle. No, Your Honor, I did not have sex with a waffle iron, as indicated by Mr. Tingle.
Or some sort
Exhibit
of B, file.
This is not me having wild, passionate sex with a velociraptor.
You know, this actually inspires me a little bit. I think...
You should totally write,
you know, my words of wisdom are for people to...
Okay, there we go.
Be inspired by this, you know, subgenre, and to make and also be inspired by Chuck Tingle, and, you know, go out and write any kind of bizarre story or make any kind of bizarre movie about any celebrity that you want, and maybe it'll take off. Maybe you'll be a trendsetter. Maybe you'll be a groundbreaker. Maybe you'll make some sort of new subgenre that no one's even thought of before. And it doesn't have to be erotic, you know, but it helps. You know, what I would love to see a series of sci-fi, kung fu, erotic novels and movies. And all with all Bruces, you can do that if you want. Keep the Bruce train going. And involve dinosaurs if you want. But don't take too much from Chuck Tingle. Let him do his own thing, too. I think he also has some Bigfoot erotica also. So... But, you know...
He also has an RPG system.
He does, really?
Yeah.
Oh, huh. Man, what a prolific man that this Mr. Tingle is. But anyway, try to be a groundbreaker. Try to be a trendsetter. Try to just think outside the box, you know?
So what you're saying, what we're going to end with today is it doesn't have to be erotic, but it helps.
Exactly.
Okay, yeah. There we are, folks.
If you take nothing else... If you take nothing else from this whole program, just take that.
There we go. All right, folks. That's your words of wisdom for this time. And we will see you next time. Which I think the next one we're going to do might be Warriors of the Wasteland. I think it's doable.
Ooh, that sounds fun.
Oh, yeah. All right, so, ciao!